Hey fishing friend, my name is JC with Rad Reeling Fishing. In this video, I'm going to show you the two knots that are the best knots for tying on your fishing lures to monofilament or fluorocarbon fishing line. I use these knots exclusively all the time. They're the best knots. They are the easiest knots and they're pretty darn quick to tie once you learn how to tie them. Now I've got over 820 videos related to fishing in my library, so make sure you subscribe and let's get on with this fishing knot tying tutorial. This first knot is going to be your best knot that you can use for like topwater lures or like, let's say, big swim baits or snook jigs, any lure that doesn't have a snap ring. This one's got a snap ring on it, but you notice this topwater lure right here doesn't have a snap ring on it. So in order to demonstrate this, how to tie this knot so that you can see it, we're just going to pretend that this circle hook right here is the eye of a lure that doesn't have the snap ring on it. So we're going to come up on our main line. This is going to be monofilament or fluorocarbon, and we are going to tie an overhand knot like you would tie on your shoe, but we're not going to cinch it down tight. We're going to leave it like that. Next thing that we do, take the tag end and we thread it through the eye of the lure. Then we bring the tag end from underneath of the overhand knot that we tied, just push it through from underneath. And then we just want to kind of, we're creating a loop here. This is called a no-slip loop knot. Then we're just going to kind of hold right here at the knot. We're going to take our tag end and we're going to wrap it three times. One, two, three times. And then we're going to go back through both loops that we created. We created the big loop here, and then we have the smaller loop on the overhand knot. Then we're going to take the tag in. We're going to stick it through both loops, but we're going to do it in the opposite direction. So when we put it in the overhand knot, we came from underneath. Now we're going to put it in from on top, but we're going through both loops. And then we're going to adjust this loop down as far as we want it to be, how close we want it to be to the lure. So I can adjust it down really close or I can have it out here. So I'm just going to go ahead and cinch this down. I'm holding the tag end and I'm just kind of pushing the knot here and I cinch it down there. So that is your no slip loop knot. And what that does is when you tie that onto a lure, it allows the lure to have more flexibility and action. So for instance, when you're working a topwater lure, when you're walking the dog, okay, you pull that lure one way and it goes there. You pull it again and it automatically goes the other direction. You pull it again and it goes the other direction. So that loop knot allows for more flexibility for the lure to do that zigzag action. Let me talk about, if I was tying on a snook jig, I would tie it on with the same type knot. I would tie it on with a loop knot. The good thing about the loop knot when you are fishing for big fish is this, let's say a snook just swallows this down like inside of his mouth. What happens if you've got the double protection from the fish's teeth wearing through the line, right? If you only had one line coming off of the knot, you don't have as much abrasion resistance as you do when you have two lines coming off of the lure. So whenever I tie on a snook jig, I like to use a large loop, pretty good size loop like that. I'm generally fishing at night when I'm fishing for snook, so it gives you that double protection against the abrasion resistance against the snook's teeth. Big swim baits that don't have the snap ring, I use a loop knot on those. Small paddle tails, just about any lure that doesn't have a snap ring, I'm going to use the no slip loop knot method. The other thing is you can always take these snap rings off, right, and just tie directly to the eye on the lure. You know, that'll keep you from bending out a snap ring if you hook onto a really big fish. Okay, so the next knot, you guys, this is going to be, if you have a snap ring on your lure, this is going to be the best knot that you can tie. It's easy, it's simple. So here again, we're going to pretend that this is your split ring. I keep calling it a snap ring. I think it's called a split ring, right? Anyway, so we're going to pretend that's your snap ring. We're going to put the tag in through the split ring. Then we're going to double it. We're going to put it through again, right? We're going to put it through there twice, and that gives us that that loop. And then we're going to bring our main line up. Then we're going to bring our main line up like this. We're going to take the tag in and we're going to wrap it around the main line several times, depending on the pound test line that you're using. So if you're using heavier pound test, you might wrap it like 4 or 5 times. If you're using a lighter pound test, you might wrap it like 7 or 8 to 10 times. So I'm just going to wrap it about 3 times, and then I'm going to put it through both loops that I created there. This is called a trilene knot. It's basically, it's kind of like it's a clinch knot. And then I'm going to cinch this down, right? I'm just going to pull this down tight. This is basically a clinch knot, but trilene improved the clinch knot. And they call it a trilene knot. This knot right here, guys, this is the strongest knot that you can use for tying on a lure or even your fishing hook, right? And the reason I say that is there was an online video channel called Knot Wars, and it came down between the trilene knot and the Palomar knot, and the trilene knot won the competition of what the strongest knot was that you could use for tying on your hooks or your lures. So I'm going to use this knot, right, whenever I've got the split ring on my lure. If you're pompano fishing, right, you've got a jig and a teaser, and you don't have the split ring that are holding the two together, you can tie those together with the first knot, the loop knot that I showed you. So I did want to tell you with the no-slip loop knot, you can adjust that and make that loop knot as small as you want, right? So you can see there, that loop knot is smaller than the first one that I tied. I mean, you could adjust that right down and have the knot like right close to your lure if you wanted to adjust it down that close.
Hey, check out this video right here. I show you 3 ways that you can attach braided line to monofilament or fluorocarbon leader. Check out this one. I show you a lot of different ways to rig paddle tails. Thumbs up are appreciated. Get out there and go fishing, man. Life is fun. Live it. See ya!